Tiki Kon Air, it takes you there, and we're here to take you to Iron Tiki Tender 2015! The contestants here that you see before you have been through an arduous process finding the best combination of recipes using our sponsor's products, the sponsor's Appleton Rum and BG Reynolds Syrups, of course, I'm sure you're all very familiar with. They entered an online competition where their drinks were judged from a field of thousands of bits. It's a funny computer joke. To find who was making the best tropical cocktails, and that brought them here today to win the grand prize of $1,000 and the ability to call yourself Iron Tiki Tender 2015. So, I would like to introduce our contestants. Starting off over here, we have Mike Treffen from from Rum Club here in our very own Portland, Oregon. So, Mike, speaking of mics, I'm having issues with. So, Mike, what makes you think that you're the Iron Tiki Tender for 2015?
I got the heart.
Woo, heart!
The heart is, it's literally right here. You have to look at his shirt. It's beautiful. All right, we've got Sierra Kirk from our very own Holly Pele, Portland, Oregon! Now, Sierra, what makes you think that you are the Iron Tiki Tender for 2015?
I shine the brightest.
Indeed she does. Don't get too close to the shirt. It's blinding. My retinas are having issues. And all the way from Seattle, Washington, at the Diller Room, Justin Foyswag! Justin, what makes you Iron Tiki Tender 2015?
I spent hours away from my family working on these recipes.
No. Justin has advised me that he is a shriner, an actual fez-carrying shriner, and were he to win, that $1,000 would be going towards the Shriners Hospital. So, no hard feelings. Just putting it out there. All right. And sitting here, in judgment of them, is our fine, established panel of judges. We've got here Jim Romdahl from Rumba in Seattle. We've got Samantha Bacall from the Oregonian. Martin Kate of Smuggler's Cove in San Francisco and Whitechapel of San Francisco.
Someday.
2015. Yeah. And our very own Mike Shea from Rub Club here in Portland, Oregon. Wait a second. I see.
I will also only Holly be his Pele hardest Sierra, judge.
It's all numerics. It's all numerics. Anyway, wanted to thank you all for being here to see this competition. We've got a great couple of rounds for our bartenders to compete in to see who is truly the best Iron Tiki Tender. We've got round one. Round one is going to be called our Speed Tiki Round. They're going to be making 6 classic tropical cocktails in under 8 minutes. Any tropical bartender worth their salt should be able to do this, but combined between all the drinks, there are over 30 ingredients. So this is going to be a lot of, you got to have a speedy jigger to get this going. Round two is a very famous round. It takes the best photos. Our garish garnish contest. The bartenders will have 8 minutes to build the most garish garnish they can, and a few minutes after that to set it on fire. And round three will be the classic Iron Tiki Tender round. We have a secret ingredient that has yet to be revealed to anybody, judges or contestants, maybe even myself. And they'll be trying to create the most creative cocktails to bring to our judges. So, let's see. Judges, are we ready?
Ready.
All right. Competitors, how's your bar set up? Mike? Yes.
This first round, how exactly are we being scored? Is it a combination of speed and taste of ingredients, or like what's going on?
I don't have to tell you how to score. We're married men.
You're already being judged.
You're being judged by not only the drinks. Not only how many drinks you make, but the quality thereof. They will be brought to the judges' table for scoring. So, all right. Jim, are we ready with the jam box?
Yes.
Then, Speed Tiki. 6 drinks, 8 minutes. Are we ready? Bartenders, hands up. And go!
Thank you.
right, they're getting their bartender, their glasses set up, getting everything going. Now, one of the products that you're going to be seeing being slung here is, of course, Fiji Reynolds syrups. If you didn't know, the hotel bar has been mixing with Fiji Reynolds syrups and mixers here throughout Tiki Kon. I hope you've been able to enjoy some of the tropical cocktails that were available. And of course, they're available at most of your local retailers. Fiji Reynolds syrups are made here in Portland, Oregon, from only the finest ingredients, made by a bartender, me, for bartenders and home mixologists. The other product, and one of our fantastic sponsors, is Appleton Rum. Appleton Rum provided some Ray and Nephew Overproof, some Appleton Gold and Silver, and of course, something we go through a lot of at Hale Pele, Karuba. It's fine, fine products, and I highly recommend using them for your mixing. So, judges, what are we seeing here? We've got some technical scoring to do. How are they doing as far as that?
There's a lot of things going in jiggers and a lot of things going in glassware.
I see some free pouring over on the bar side. Any thoughts on that as far as a technical bartender goes?
If it tastes good.
Word on the street is you have some very fast bartenders at Smuggler's Cove.
That's correct, Blair. Indeed we do, extremely fast. They take a lot of pride in it. It tends to, delights and amazes our guests who've been known to burst into applause periodically as they build 6, 8, 10 at a time horizontally. It's a lot of fun.
It's when they can start getting it vertically. That would be more fascinating. I think stacked cocktails are going to be the next big trend.
I think so. It's amazing to watch, and it's some real Rain Man stuff going on.
Now, a sign of a good bartender that I'm seeing here is some tasting of the cocktails. You can make them as fast as you can. You can make sure the drinks are the ingredients are as accurate as possible. If it doesn't taste good, what's the point? Cocktails that our bartenders here are going to be making. We've got the Zombie Punch, the classic from Don the Beachcomber. Of course, there has to be a Mai Tai, goes well, from Trader Vic, Oakland, 1944. We've got the Nui Nui, a personal favorite. Nice concoction full of spice and citrus. The Derby Daiquiri, a classic from Mai Kai in Florida. We've got the Honey Honey, which comes from way back in the day, Trader Vic's book, Food and Drink. And of course, the classic Test Pilot from Don the Beachcomber. Of course, the next challenge to making the drinks is seeing which of our judges can drink all of them in one session. How you feeling, Justin?
I've been a huge mess back here.
It's not speedy if it ain't sticky. Sierra, how many drinks you got lined up so far?
All of them.
Nice, nice. Mike, things are looking good over here. How confident are you? You're going to finish in time.
Yeah, man, pretty good. Feeling good.
Excellent. Just about 3 minutes left. And I think these bartenders are showing their skills. And that's why they're here for the Iron Tiki stage.
the double shake.
Power move. I think that's a power move. It's a way to show your dominance. You expect too much.
Highly unconventional, no Hawthorne sooner method.
If you're done, put your hands up. All right, Justin.
Oh, yeah.
Got just a little bit of time. Oh. Nah, next track's feeding in. Yeah, it was. Nope. Pause. Of course, if you're looking for the secrets of tropical bartending, you're going to want to follow Mindy Kushan, Holly Pele's own bartender, and the 2012, I believe it was, Iron Tiki Tender. She recently had a class today on how to bring professional techniques to your home tiki bar. We're going to be trying to see her at a few more tropical events as well. Justin, are you run? Time! All right!
Did everyone finish early?
Everyone finished early!
Hey!
Hey! John Mill, would you mind helping me bring it? All right, they're going to bring the cocktails to the judges for judgery. Just bring it over, everybody's in a group. Grouping. All right, so let's take a look at these cocktails. I see a Nui Nui, the three dots. We got a Honey. Oh, nope. Excuse me, the Test Pilot. Honey Honey and the Derby Daiquiri. I'm just trying to throw you off. See how your game is. Oh, these are some beautiful looking cocktails. Folks, do these look pretty good cocktails?
All right.
I know I'm feeling thirsty.
Okay.
All right.
Can we try each drink from each contestant at the same time?
Or new.
And then so that they're all judged?
No, that's Nui Nui.
That's the Nui Nui.
Can we try each drink from each contestant at the same time?
So happy to do that.
So that they are not watering down at the
same time.
That would
be the best
thing. So they're on the same level, please.
What was that?
You want to taste all three Mai Tais?
We have to
all
wait
three
for his. They're
going
to get watery. We have
yeah.
to do one at a time. Right. So we should do all three
yeah.
at each time.
All right, let's pull them down.
Okay, so let's line up by groups. Mike's zombie, Sierra's zombie.
Yeah,
and we can start over here with the other ones with cases to go.
So the bartenders are fast, but the service is kind of questionable.
Okay.
So Mike,
Justin.
Mike,
Gabrielle's
Justin
out of practice.
Across, so.
Okay.
Standards were set.
Who's this?
Mike.
Mike.
I'll bring cocktails to
you.
Okay.
We'll figure it out.
I don't know which one's what.
We do, as long as you know which, who it came from.
Mike's the zombie.
Oh, awesome.
Sierra's zombie.
All right, so have you folks been enjoying the sights and sounds of Portland, Oregon, all the way over there? Has everyone gotten a chance to go out on the city a little bit? We've had some fantastic shows, some fantastic some music. The VIP room, of course, is very popular. Who's had some Dole Whip? Any VIPs in the audience? Oh, yeah. It just, nothing like it in the world.
Mike, Sierra, Justin.
And once we've got these cocktails over to the judges, we are going to clear the way for the Garish Garnish contest.
My time. Sierra, my time.
All right, bartenders, wipe your bar tops off. We got to bring some pretty, pretty turtles from the folks at Monk Tiki up to your bars.
Justin, my time.
Okay.
This is...
Yeah, it's always me and Mike, Sierra, Justin.
And you're handing me Mike.
Yep.
Mike, and this is Test Pilot.
All right. It's a lot of cinnamon up there, Justin. I think you know I approve of that.
All right, Jabra, would you grab the turtle bowls and sit them on the stage?
Thank you so much. So next we're stepping into our garish garnish competition. This is one of our most photo-friendly competitions at... You will be waiting to light it on fire at the end. At that point, anybody who wants to take some photography, take some own personal shots, we'll ask you to please come up to the stage and see the fire. All right. So these big, beautiful turtle bowls are given to us by my good friends at Monk Tiki. Monk Tiki makes some of the finest tiki mugs you've ever seen. They've been doing it for a lot longer than most. Do we have... Oh, there's Paul. Paul! Woo! Recently, they've been going into another direction with the Stein business. Most recently, they had the Bigfoot Stein, father and son Bigfoot team. I know I put in for my Kickstarter on that one. Still sad that it didn't get the lid. I think that would have been such a good addition. All right, get your bowls full of crushed ice, and we're going to be ready to go. Okay, Jabra. They're going to need more crushed ice for the next round. All right, bartenders, are those turtles full of ice?
Not yet.
You were so fast last round at this. I'm disappointed.
Where's the rabbit?
Yeah. Where is the rabbit? Is that like what the fox, what does the fox say? Okay. Judges, how are those cocktails?
Not too shabby.
Very delicious cocktails.
You know, and I think that comes from using the finest ingredients like B.G. Reynolds syrups.
I love those ingredients.
Yeah. Good place to score, Blair.
All right. So we got crushed ice in every turtle. Bartenders?
Okay.
Just about ready?
Yep.
All right, bartenders, hands up. Music cue. And let's begin the most garish garnish competition. Go! Woo! I believe I see some shrunken heads over at Mike's table. Now, contestants were allowed to pre-prepare a little bit of garnish, just as long as we made sure that they had a good show to give to you folks. When it comes to garnish, I think tropical cocktails really have everybody else beat. I don't know if you've... Who here's been to Hale Pele? And who here's going back? All right. That's what I like to hear, please. I got three kids. They're all going to want to go through college. We've got... The thing about Hale Pele, and when I was designing the drinks and putting everything together, I wanted to make sure that the garnish was the best it could be, that it was big, that it was bold, that it was bright, that it was lovely, that every drink was worthy of a picture that you could put on your social media, show to your friends, and that something that said, wow, even with just the visual, that this drink is high quality. And these bartenders have learned some lessons from what we're doing there. Now, once you've got the quality, it's time to pack on some of the quantity too. And our bowls are, as we're seeing here, are some pretty crazy stuff. We've had volcano bowls with little boats and sinkers. It's nice to have a little fun with your garnish now and then. Of course, I always like to think the garnish is the experience of the tiki bar, the volcanoes, the rainstorms. Are those peacocks? All right, I'm hearing kind of a disturbing sound from over here. Can I just... I gotta say, I think that's maybe the second or third cocktail I've ever heard chant, although usually it's after about four or five. And Sierra, I'm seeing a bevy of, we've got some skulls, some mermaids, a pineapple island. Well, explain what's going on here.
It's a volcano, and there's sea serpents and battleships, and yeah, mermaids.
Beautiful, beautiful. Flower lava, of course. Now, what are these little fellas?
Those are great.
Pretty cute, fun. She's got a peacock tattooed on her back, so it's in theme. She has actually been theming herself over the years in preparation for this contest. All for today. All right, stepping over here. Wow, there are some good, there's some strange geometries coming over here at Justin's.
Too kind, too kind.
Oh, this is, ooh. I can feel the heat coming from it already. Oh, yeah. That is the biggest. Now, see, so at Holly Paley, we do this little thing where we put some breadcrumbs and orange extract. It's super high proof, and it's, it makes a really nice flame after setting on a fire. Justin's got like a loaf of bread in here. A bit bigger than a breadcrumb. Oh, and home baked, of course. Judges, how are you feeling about those round one cocktails?
So far, everybody did a pretty good job with the cocktails. They're all pretty balanced. There's some little tweaks here and there between them. But overall, it's a pretty even playing field for the cocktails.
Excellent. Any favorites? Not amongst the competitors. What about the cocktails?
The zombie spec was my favorite of the round.
Yeah, it kind of has a history of...
I'd have to agree there.
Yeah.
The zombie's the best.
I see the one that's been sipped down the most. That's kind of indicative.
That was specifically my favorite zombie.
Oh, that ain't shabby. We have the enchanting sounds of Ima Sumac trying to drown out Mike's chanting volcano over there. So, Mike, I'm seeing what appears to be shrunken human skulls. Can you explain the process in making these here?
It's really all about death. Death and love.
Are these actual human shrunken skulls?
Yes.
Where did you get them? Because my source ran out.
We'll talk later.
Wow, this is colorful, Sierra. Not unlike your dress. Oh, wait. Wait a second. Is that... Oh, I know what I see. Folks, anybody know what you're seeing right here? What does that look like? I'll give you a clue. It was about... a week ago. I think we're gonna see some sparks here.
Oh, I had to work at my other job, so I had to send my husband to buy me sparklers.
That's a good husband there.
And I'm about to touch a go.
Alright. Bartenders, how are we feeling? Is everyone ready to light? All right.
Are they done early again?
They're so good. We picked the best of the best over here. All right, so let's drown out the music as we're getting ready to fire the garish garnish. Ladies and gentlemen, you're all welcome to come over here with your electronical devices, your tintypes, your pictographs, the Vision Masters.
Oh my God.
As we light these beautiful tropical cocktails on fire.
Oh, yeah.
Give it a second for everyone to round up. I can't see him. All right. So, we probably should have gone up. You're welcome to come as close as possible, but please, some of you may be missing an eyebrow on the way out. Mike, is your cocktail ready to go? Ready to light? Light it! Oh! Wait. Kill it, kill it, kill it, kill it.
Slayer move.
Oh, God. I remember. Wait, this bald spot wasn't there before.
We'll tell your family you loved it.
Nobody's called the fire marshal on this, right? All right, they're big, they're bold, they're boisterous, and everybody should be breathing cinnamon dust. At Holly Paley, we call it the brown lung. Someday there will be a lawsuit.
It smells so good up here right now. It's just like toasty and delicious.
Mike, what are the shrunken skulls made out of?
Those are apples, which would greatly complement many tiki drinks.
Ah, excellent.
That's the classic.
The last time I remember.
Short vials of overproof rum that are attached by swords to the center pineapple, which is chanted.
Let's, I don't think it's safe to get over there to hear the chanting. Can you give us a replication of the chanting?
It goes a little bit,
Hookah, 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 chaka, hookah, chaka. I can't stop this feeling. No, seriously, it's so hot over here.
Get a little coverage.
Yeah.
Cinnamon!
It's coming from inside the pineapple.
Inside the pineapple! The secret tribe of pineapple men living inside. All right. So Sierra, explain to us yours.
Mine is a battleship seen around a volcano that is now up in flames, pretty much. The ships were being pulled down by sea serpents and mermaids. The chrysanthemums were the lava, and everything is on fire.
Excellent, excellent. And Justin, I think if there is a heat score, you won it. Hardcore. Hard time over here.
Sun.
What kind of fireproof hair gel are you using? Because explain to us what you've made here.
It was kind of built up sort of like a pyramid. I had a pineapple ring that's totally singed now, but the idea was to have the fire shoot through it, which it did, which is awesome. Some additional lime pods say they're on fire. Orchids, pineapple leaves. I thought it looked cool.
Excellent, excellent. Well, now the big challenge is going to be how the hell you're going to put it out. Yeah. All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, if you could, please return to your seats, and thank you for joining us for the most garish garnish. Judges, what do you have to say about these pillaring towers of flame?
So, Blair, I've got this to say.
Can they be executed on Saturday nights when it's four deep?
There's actually a layer of cinnamon everywhere.
There is. Yes. Wow. Everything tastes better with cinnamon. Derby daiquiris, honey honies.
Someone once walked into Holly Paley saying they had a cinnamon allergy.
It smells amazing up here.
I
right
said
now.
If that were real.
It just smells like this
you
is like the most amazing smelling stage I've ever seen in my life.
What's that?
I've worked in rock clubs for a long time. This is the most amazing smelling stage I've ever been on right now. So.
All right, bartenders, if you could clean up your turtles, let's take those away.
Can we? Uh-huh. I'd like
please
to go
extinguish
see the turtles,
your turtles.
Since we actually can't see anything.
Go take a look.
We would like to observe first.
Judges, go observe.
I can't see them.
That's true.
Yeah.
Let's go look.
Well, specifically, we stuck you in that corner.
I gotta wipe the cinnamon off my camera lens.
Because I'm gonna fall off the edge of the stage, okay. Which is frightening me.
I can't tell you what that looks like. I've always said my favorite garnish for competitions is $20 bills. So Jim, what is this we got here?
It appears to be tiny vials of some sort of liquid substance hidden within the icy flaming garnish.
Are those chicken bones? You got chicken bones here?
Yeah, those didn't make it on.
Oh, that damn shame. Here, well, they're still there for wishing on.
No one wins.
Nobody wins. That was a chicken bone that Mike had brought for the garnish that didn't make it. That Jim and Mike shared, and the middle snapped off. Nobody wins. Bribes for the judges. No, nope. Audience, any bribes for the audience? Anybody? No? No, sir? No.
That's a really lovely plant.
It's adorable. There's no hair to support. You just had to poke it in your head.
Stab myself with it.
All right. Bartenders, take down those turtles so we can get you going with the Iron Tiki Tender Round. Mike Shea asked here, what's the tiki factor? The tiki factor is something the judges are judging upon. A tiki factor, for me, is when you're creating a tropical drink, what makes it fit into the pantheon of tropical drinks? And there's a few ways you can do about that. It's a modification on a drink from Don the Beachcomber or Trader Vic. Drinks that have a basis in like the Planner's Punch or the Daiquiri. And then just that last final wow factor, that mystery. Something good tropical drinks have always had, at least for me, is that sense of what is that in there that's making this so good? There's always something unique, something interesting that brings it out of your normal palate and into the tropical or exotic atmospheres. And that, for me, is the tiki factor.
Thank you, Blair.
Flaming also helps. Big, fiery garnish. All right. No bonus points awarded for using Hale Pele glassware. Available at Hale Pele, 2733 North East Broadway, across from Pets on Broadway. Committed to using the tiki mug? All right. You're making four drinks. So, for round three, you're going to be making four drinks. You're going to be creating an original creation with our secret ingredient. Any
secret
guesses what our
ingredient.
Secret ingredient? Any guesses as to what it could be?
Pork.
Pork?
No.
Kale.
Columbia River water.
Marionberries.
The secret ingredient is now legal in Washington.
Marionberries, what?
And of course, my personal favorite, the secret ingredient is love. Hey, who's been messing with the machine? All right, but bartenders, are we just about ready for the reveal? Okay. Getting up some glassware? Okay. This beautiful tiki mug here comes from Hale Pele, of course, and our friends at Monk Tiki. They recently started the Monk Tiki Imports line, a way to make mugs affordable for your tiki bar. So when is the Dilla Room Tiki Tuesday is getting its own mug?
Fundraise for it. Essentially, when I get crowd fundraise for it.
Do a little Kickstarter or something like that? Yeah. Or just...
Until the next time I work, technically, as a tiki artist, I change the music on Tuesdays, essentially. Any night I'm working, I technically knock out tiki drinks, but Tuesday I'll change the music around. We're more of a... it's more of a whiskey bar that I brought a rum program into.
Yeah, but I've heard you got a lot of press recently.
Yeah. Super cool, yeah. Real nice. Seattle Times and the Seattle Weekly.
Fantastic. As they say, keep the tiki torch burning. All right. Mike, are you set up with glassware? Woo! Sierra, are you set up with glassware? All right. We got two more tiki mugs to go, and we're going to be ready for this year's Iron Tiki Tender. Now, everybody's been wondering. Everybody's been waiting. What is the secret ingredient?
Tell us, Blair.
The secret ingredient is... something I have been needing a lot this weekend. Cold press coffee!
Coffee?
We've got a little bit of cold press coffee. Made most famous in drinks such as the Black Magic at the Mai Kai in Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
Where is that cold press coffee sourced from?
Locally sourced from a Trader Joe's.
It might be true.
The secret ingredient is out. The glassware is out. Bartenders, hands up. Start. Woo!
Yeah!
Now, they're going to be trying to create an original tropical cocktail using this secret ingredient. Cold-pressed coffee is a challenge. While it can be delicious, it can also be incredibly bitter. It pairs well with a few things. Again, as made most famous in the Black Magic is served at the Mai Kai. Coffee has a long history, actually. One of the first in tropical drinks, one of the first Don the Beachcomber menus had a Kona coffee grog. I know. It looks like Trader Joe's is going to be changing his name here. Yeah, there might be a cease and desist on that. Don't change that name. So, Tim, I know you've worked with coffee at some various spots. Have you noticed any, what do you feel about mixing coffee with cocktails?
We have a new drink at Rumba going on the menu with some cold-pressed coffee concentrate. Using a real robust rum, orgeat, and coconut cream. It makes for really fun, really kind of robust tiki drinks where it kind of acts as a balancer that citrus would, so you don't have to use citrus if you don't wish. That's my favorite use of it.
Awesome.
And Samantha, you're a fan of coffee?
Huge.
You live in Portland, you have to have coffee.
Naturally.
Yeah. What? Tell us about some of your favorite coffee combinations.
I like coffee and chai together. Mm-hmm. Just a little bit of that spice from the...
So you're really bringing in the spice again.
Yep.
So spice and coffee, orgeat and coffee. I'm starting to hear some hints. These bartenders might want to be listening in. Martin, is there anything coffee going on at the Cove?
What? we have a drink that features the Bitterman's New Orleans liqueur, which is a really concentrated sort of espresso liqueur. So it works like an Amaro. Yeah, really sharp and strongly flavored.
Jay, anything at Rum Club featuring coffee bitters, or?
Well, we actually don't actually have hot coffee during the summertime. We only have coffee toddy that we make locally from one of our local roasters. And coffee concentrate's a great addition to any kind of rum drink, essentially. So.
Excellent. And the greatest thing is when the bartenders are making the coffee shots, you know, the drinks are actually going to be better, faster, more accurate.
Yeah.
But that's also how you hide Fernet shots. I know at Holly Paley we use cold pressed coffee in a drink called the Krakatoa. Krakatoa, one of a few of our flamingest cocktails at Holly Paley. Built tall, pairs with passion fruit and Don's mix, the cold pressed coffee, and a little bit of juice. Very, very delicious drink, and just a dash of overproof rum just makes it sing. And of course, it's served with a little orange peel volcano. Quite lovely.
So Blair,
yes.
It always comes down to this last round, right? It always comes down to the last round. Can we get a hell yeah for the competitors right now? Can we get a shout out from the crowd? Is it here like, come on, let's hear like a pump up for the crowd, come on.
They're doing some great drinks while I'm berating them with horrible dialogue. Mike, it looks like your confidence levels are high here. You found a good flavor combination? Sarah, how are things going over here?
Delicious. Yeah.
Excellent. Good. And Justin, are you? Justin's done. Jeez. I think coming up next year, I'm going to be picking the second best entries for the Iron Tiki Tender competition. These guys are just too good. All right. I'm going to start bringing drinks to the table here. I think the color of the tiki mug is very complimentary to the coffee as well.
Yeah.
So I'm going to bring you over here to talk about your cocktail that you made in front of the judges. About wrapping things up. Again, a quick round. We got the best of the best. What can I say? All right. A little garnish to make it lovely. And done! All right. All of our bartenders again, finished ridiculously early. Yeah, not ridiculously. So, Justin, I'd like to invite you over here to please step in front of our judges.
Where's the last drink?
You're gonna grab the mic from me, and I want you to give them an explanation of your cocktail. Judges, would you please be sure to ask take a taste and ask Justin any questions on his lovely concoction here.
How's it going? So it's a citrus blend, dark Jamaican rum, some of the cold pressed coffee, and some spices number two. I think the flavors worked well together. Tried out one, I liked it, so I made four.
What spices?
Spices number two.
Oh,
Don spices.
I believe you mean the rebranded Tiki spices, available from BG Reynolds Syrups.
Only the best.
They burned coasters.
Nice. Justin, will you run down all of the ingredients you got in there?
Sure thing. It's lemon, pineapple, dark Jamaican rum, the cold pressed coffee, spices number two.
That was the only sugar you used?
Yeah. Rebranded. That's all I have, yeah.
Okay, cool.
Justin,
thank you.
Do you have a name for your drink?
I didn't have the time to think of one. I got
Justin's cocktail.
Justin's cocktail.
Thank you, Justin.
Shriner's Delight. Shriner's Delight. A little shot of Shriner.
Thank you, Justin.
All right. Coming next, Mike, I'd like to come up to the judges' table. It's the problem with living in Portland. There's so much good food, it's hard to fit through tight spaces.
Uh-huh. Jeez.
Oh, don't think I don't know.
Got a little shady out here, didn't it? So for my cocktail, I did... I really love making coffee cocktails, but I feel like coffee has enough acidity so much already that typically I would use like a cream sort of element or like a fat element. So barring that, I used orange juice and orgeat with a little bit of Don spices number two. There's a touch of cinnamon as well. Gold Jamaican rum, as well as a little bit of overproof rum. There's a full ounce of the cold brew in there, and so I think that it needs a good rum backbone to sort of balance off that. And then also the final ingredient was Adam Elmadrob's Aphrodite bitters, which have a little bit of cayenne, some cocoa nibs, that kind of thing, which I think actually really work very nicely with coffee. So that, the cherry Angostura on top of the mint, which aromatically I thought would sort of bring some really nice bass tones into it.
Judges, any questions for Mike?
No, that explained a lot of things. It was a lengthy explanation.
I feel like I got it all, man.
It was a lengthy explanation.
No, detail, thank you.
Thorough.
He's a good man and thorough. All right. Up next, Sierra Kirk from Hale Pele. Now, I've noticed there was a little detail that you brought here for your drink. Can you show the audience?
Well, I wasn't sure what the ingredient would be, but I figured it would look nice. So I made some little coasters, and I named my drink The Secret of the Lost Lagoon. And I planned all that out so I wouldn't have to think about it at all. But yeah.
Tell us what's in it.
It's got a little bit of dark rum and overproof rum. Again, I wanted something to kind of stand up to the coffee. I did vanilla and ginger because I like those flavors in my non-alcoholic coffee beverages. And then I did a little bit of lime and pineapple to balance out the acidity, even though they're pretty acidic, but I feel like they're bright enough to kind of keep it tart and refreshing.
What was the base again? I'm sorry to interrupt.
What now?
What was the base again?
I did dark rum and overproof rum.
Thank you.
And then about half an ounce of the overproof, or of the coffee, rather, in each cocktail as
Got
well.
It.
Overproof coffee.
Yes, overproof coffee, the best kind of coffee.
It is overproof coffee. It's concentrated.
Yes, exactly.
Great, thank you so much, Sierra. All right, so judges, I'd like you to get together your final tally, if you could, for me. Unfortunately, we didn't have the Jeopardy music queued up, otherwise that would be fun. But in the meantime, I wanted to take just a moment to thank everybody. Thank, of course, all of you wonderful people for coming out here to Iron Tiki Tender and Tiki Kon. And, of course, for visiting Hale Pele and, again, keeping my children going to college. Our contestants here, Mike Trefane from Rum Club. Sarah Kirk from Hale Pele. And Justin Weiswaff from the Dilla Room in Seattle. Our lovely stage assistants, Jabril Donahue and Janet Ludi. They're both my employees at BG Reynolds Syrups, and they're getting ready to change the world. And of course, our esteemed panel of judges. I'd like to thank our sponsors, Appleton Rums, of course, some of the finest rums in Jamaica. It's, the great thing is about having great sponsors is I don't have to lie and say they're some of the best rums on the planet. I know my personal favorites. And of course, BG Reynolds Syrups. Available in Portland, Oregon. Available for sale at Hale Pele. And hopefully soon in a retail store near you. Who thinks they're the furthest out coming here to Tiki Kon? Oh, where are you coming from? Toronto, Canada? Oh, it's a whole other nation away. Oh, you got her beat? Florida! Oh, where you got? Where? Barcelona!
Winner!
I know a bartender from Spain who tried to enter the contest who's going to be very upset that he wasn't on that plane ride with you.
Is that not a limerick?
What's that?
There once was a bartender from Spain. No.
There once was a bartender from Spain who said he could make in the rain. No.
Yeah, get in there.
Yeah, we're working on it. Judges, how's deliberation going?
We're going to deliberate around the corner.
They're going to deliberate around the corner a little bit. So bartenders will be tidying up their stations. So the judges are deliberating on who we're going to hand out these lovely plaques to. These plaques, made by a very good friend of mine, Dave Hansen, also known as Lake Tiki. He does some wonderful carvings, some of which you'll see at Hale Pele. And it's been such a joy to watch him just get better and better. We've got them small, medium, and large for the winner. Judges, do we have a decision?
Sure.
All right. Our very own Martin Kate of Smuggler's Cove in San Francisco.
You can stand for the
team. You ready?
All right.
And I will be the lovely assistant handing out the awards.
All right.
You want a first, a second, and a third?
I will start with third.
All right. Start with third.
Are you guys all ready? It's pretty exciting stuff because we had some amazing competitors up here. I think I would love to hear another round of applause for all three, please. Yeah. We all had the great fortune of tasting some fantastic drinks, of seeing some excellent technique, and some great showmanship. So we all win, and we're very happy. However, there can be only one. But the good news is we have three trophies. In third place, Justin.
Let's hear it.
Weiswaff.
What?
Weiswaff.
I'm not. You say it. Weiswaff. Weiswaff.
How did he do?
No,
all right. Okay. He nailed it. Good. It took a little work. All right. In second place. Now, bearing in mind, should the first place winner be unable to fulfill their duties as Iron Tiki Tender anytime during the course of 2015-2016, the runner-up will take over. So this is a very important role. So in second place, it is Michael. Which means, coming to you from Portland, Oregon's own Hale Pele, first place winner, Sierra! Sierra is going to be taking home the $1,000 prize to help gussy up the cinnamon damage from Hale Pele. So, ladies, and you get to keep your job. So ladies and gentlemen, once again, thank you so much for coming out to Iron Tiki Tender. We're going to strike the stage so you can enjoy some music. We'll see you next year in 2016. All right.